In this video, I'll continue with numerical inequalities. Before solving some more problems on inequalities, we will see closed interval, open interval, and how an inequality can be represented on a number line. First, I'll start with integers. Now, let x be any integer and the value of x lies between 6 and 10. That is, x is an integer and 6 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 10. In this case, the solution set will be, the solution set is nothing but those values which x can take. So, the solution set is 6, 7, 8, 9 and. So, here x is an integer and value of x lies between 6 and 10, and that too 6 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 10. So here we have to include both 6 and 10. On the other hand, let us take an example where x is an integer and 6 less than x less than 10. In this case, the solution set will be 7, 8 and 9. That is, x can take the values 7, 8 and 9. Here 6 and 10 are not included because it is given 6 less than x less than 10. We should not include 6 and 10. Now we will see the case when x is a real number. Say suppose if x is a real number and let us say 2 less than or equal to x less than or equal to. Here we cannot write the solution set as 2, 3 and 4 because here x is not an integer, it is a real number. It means x can take values all those that lie between 2 and 4. So in this case we write the solution set as 2, x belongs to closed interval 2 comma. So if we have 2 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 4, then the where x is a real number, then the solution set is x belongs to closed interval 2 comma. On the other hand, if x is a real number and if we have 2 less than x less than 4, you see here, this type of inequalities are called strict inequalities and these type of inequalities are called slack inequalities. So here in case of strict inequality, when 2 less than x less than 4, here the solution set will be all those points between 2 and 4 without including 2 and if from 2 to 4, but this point 2 and 4 will not be included. So here the solution set is x belongs to open interval 2 comma. Here the meaning is x belongs to closed interval 2 comma 4 means here 2 and 4 are included and all points between 2 and 4 are included. Here x belongs to open interval 2 comma 4 means 2 and 4 are not included and only those points from 2 to 4 are. So for any real number x and if a less than or equal to x less than or equal to b, then we say the solution set as closed interval a comma b. X belongs to closed interval a comma b. On the other hand, if x is a real number and if c less than x less than d, then the solution set will be open interval c comma d. Now we can graph these solutions on a number line so that it will be easy for us to understand. So this is the number line, this is minus x and this is plus x. So here this is the origin. Here all these points will be the positive side of x and this side is the negative side of x. So if we want to graph the solution set x belongs to closed interval 2 comma 4, it means here is included from 2 to 4. That is, the point 2 and 4 are also included, and this is the graph. On the other hand, if we have x belongs to open interval 2 comma 4, in this case we should not include 2 and 4. 2 and 4 are not included, and the remaining part is, all the remaining points are included except points 2 and 4. So this is with respect to closed interval, open interval, and how we can represent the solution on a number line. Now we will solve problems. Now let us solve problems from exercise 2.3 of Applied Mathematics by M.L. Agarwal. So the first question is, solve the following system of inequalities. The first one is 4 minus 5x greater than or equal to minus 1 and 4x plus 11 less than or equal to minus 1. In my previous video, I have solved various problems where a single inequality was given. Here we have a system of inequalities and we have to solve this. That is, we have to find the solution set for x which satisfy both these inequalities. So we will take the first inequality and then solve, and then the second, and accordingly we will find the solution set. So here we have 4 minus 5x greater than minus 11. So from this we have 4 plus 11 greater than 5x, or 15 greater than 5x, or when we divide both sides by 5 we get 3 greater than x, or therefore x is less than 3. Then the second inequality is 4x plus 11 less than or equal to minus 13. So here we have 4x less than or equal to minus 13 minus 11, or 4x less than or equal to minus 24. From this we have x less than or equal to minus 6. So if we draw these two inequalities on the number line, it will be easy for us to find the solution. Or even otherwise, here it is given x is less than 3 and here x is less than or equal to minus 6. So the region which is common to these two, the points that are common to these two inequality, will be x less than or equal to minus 6. So the solution set is x belongs to open minus infinity comma closed minus 6. That is, here minus infinity is not included, whereas minus 6 is included. So we have the solution set as all those points from minus infinity to minus 6 with minus 6 included. Or we draw this on the number line. So here x less than 3 will be, from here all these points will be x less than 3. And x less than or equal to minus 6 will be, from here all these. So the points that are, which are common to x less than or equal to minus 6 and x less than 3, is all these. So we have x belongs to minus infinity comma closed minus 6 as the solution. Next question, 5x plus 1 greater than minus 24 and 5x minus 1 less than. So let us solve these two and find the solution for x. So from this we get 5x greater than minus 25, or x greater than the first inequality. From the second inequality we have 5x less than 25, or x less than 5. So we have got minus 5 less than x and x is less than 5. So if we combine these two, we get minus 5 less than x than 5. So we can directly write x belongs to open minus 5 comma 5, because here we do not have minus 5 less than or equal to, it is only minus 5 less than x. So, and here also x less than 5. So the solution set is x belongs to open minus 5 comma 5. If we want, we can graph this also. Here we have x greater than minus 5. It means from minus 5 this side, and here we have x less than 5. So it is from this point this side. So the points common to these two is all these points. I hope this is clear. Next one, minus 2 minus x by 4 less than or equal to 1 plus x by 3. And the next inequality is 3 minus x less than 4 into x minus 13. So we will take the first inequality, less than or equal to 1 plus x by 3. Or here we have cross multiplying 3 into minus 8 minus x less than or equal to 4 into 1 plus. So minus 24 minus 3x less than or equal to 4 plus 4x. So minus 28 less than or equal to 7x, or x greater than or equal to minus 4. Here 3 minus x less than 4 into x minus 13, bringing it inside, 4x minus 52. So 3 plus 52 is less than 4x plus x, 55 less than 5x, or from this we have x is greater than 7. So the points common to x greater than or equal to minus 4 and x greater than 11 will be x greater than 11. So the solution set is x belongs to open 11 comma infinity. Want, we can check with the number line. So here we have minus 4 so x greater than minus 4 will be this part, and then we have x greater than 11. X greater than 11 will be from here this part. So the points common to these two is this from here. So x belongs to 11 comma. Next question, 5x minus 7 less than 3 into x plus 3. And 1 minus 3x by 2 greater than or equal to minus 4. So let us see the solution set which satisfies both these inequalities. So here we have 5x minus 7 less than 3x plus 9, or 2x less than 9 plus 7 16, therefore x less than. Here 1 minus 3x by 2 greater than or equal to x minus 4. So from this we get 1 plus 4 greater than or equal to x plus 3x by 2. Y greater than or equal to 2x plus 3x by 2. Or 10 greater than or equal to 5x. From this we get x less than or equal to. So the points common to x less than 8 and x less than or equal to 2 will be this x less than or equal to 2 only. So the solution set is x belongs to open minus infinity and close to 2, because it is एक्स लेस और इक्वल टू टू, तो एक्स कैन टेक ऑल पॉइंट्स लेस देन और इक्वल टू टू. सो हियर वी हैव टू इंक्लूडेड, हियर माइनस इन्फिनिटी इज ओके. सो इफ यू वॉन्ट वी कैन ग्राफ दिस एंड सी, एक्स लेस देन एट विल बी फ्रॉम हियर. सो दिस इज एक्स लेस देन एट and x less than 2 will be from here. So we can see the point which is common to these two is x less than, so less than or equal to, so 2 is also equal. Next question, minus 4x plus 1 greater than or equal to 0, 3 minus 4x less than 0. So here we have minus 4x greater than or equal to minus 1. So I'm dividing by minus 1. If you divide by minus 1, that is a negative real number, the inequality reverses. So we get 4x less than or equal to 1 or x less than or equal to 1 by 4. Here from 3 minus 4x less than 0, get 3 less than 4x or x greater than 3 by 4. So here we have got one side x is less than or equal to 1 by 4 and on the other side we got x greater than 3 by 4. We see from these two inequalities there are no points that are common to these two. In this case there is not even a single point which satisfies these inequalities. Therefore the solution set is empty set. For x belongs to, or if we want to check it on the number line, we can also check it. So here it is somewhere we have 1 by 4, this is 1 by 4, here we have 3 by 4. So x less than or equal to 1 by 4 will be this side. So it will be from here, this side. X less than or equal to 3 by 4 and x greater than 3 by 4 will be right. That is, this point is not included, but so if you see there are no points which are common to these two inequalities, for the solution set is the number. So we will solve some more inequalities of different form. Here the first one is minus 8 less than or equal to 5x minus 3 less than. So when we have such type of inequalities, we can solve it simultaneously also, separately also. So this is nothing but minus 8 less than or equal to 5x minus 3 and 5x minus 3 less than. So here we have minus 8 plus 3, that is minus 5 less than or equal to 5x. Here 5x less than. So here we have minus 1 less than or equal to x. Here we have x less than, or from combining these two we get minus 1 less than x less than. Therefore solution set is here it is given, here we have got minus 1 less than or equal to x and less than. So here it is closed minus 1. Here it is open. Here 2 is not included, whereas here minus 1 is included. Next question is minus 2 less than or equal to 6x minus 1 less than. Let us try to solve this simultaneously. Here we have minus 2 less than or equal to 6x minus 1 less than 2. We add 1. Then here minus 1 plus 1 will go. So here we have minus 1 less than or equal to 6x. Then or get minus 1 by 6 less than or equal to x. Then 3 by 6. From this we have minus 1 by 6 less than or equal to x. And so the solution set is x belongs to closed minus 1 by 6 open half. So this is the solution for next question. 7 less than or equal to 3x plus 11 by 2 less than or equal to 11. So here, let's take 2 to the other side. So we get 7 into 2 less than or equal to 3x plus 11 by 2 into 2 less than or equal to 11 into. So this 2, this will get cancelled. From this we get 14 less than or equal to 3x plus 11 less than or equal to. So similar to the previous problem, we'll do it simultaneously. So here we have 14 minus 11 less than or equal to 3x less than or equal to 22 minus. Or this implies 3 less than or equal to 3x less than or equal to 11. Or we divide by 3, we get 1 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 11. Right? Therefore, the solution set is closed. Right? First, here it is 1 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 11 by 3. So the points 1 and 11 by 3 are also included. So the solution set is x belongs to first 1 comma. Next one, minus 5 less than or equal to 5 minus 3x by 2 less than or equal to 8. So here we get minus 10 less than or equal to 5 minus 3x less than or equal to. When we multiply by 2, we get this. Then we have minus 10 minus 5 less than or equal to minus 3x less than or equal to 16 minus. Or here, minus 15 less than or equal to minus 3x less than or equal to. Now, here we have minus 3. So, when we divide by minus 3, the inequality sign will be reversed. Therefore, we will get minus 15 by minus 3. Greater than or equal to minus 3 by minus 3x greater than or equal to 11 by, since we are dividing by minus 3, the inequality sign will be 3. So here we get 5 greater than or equal to x greater than or equal to minus 11 by 3, or minus 11 by 3 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 5. Therefore, the solution set is x belongs to closed 11 by 3 comma 5.
முடிச்சுட்டு வரேன்.